Good day, fellow investors. Now, I have analyzed Norilsk Nickel, which is a Russian nickel, copper, and palladium miner. And I said that I will look at the palladium environment because it's very important for the stock, as the stock derives 20-30% of its revenue from palladium sales. So, we have looked at the nickel environment, we have looked at the copper environment, and it's very important to look at the palladium environment. So let's start with what is palladium, what it is used for, what is the supply-demand situation, what is the outlook, and what are the other ways to invest in palladium if you don't like a Russian investment like Norilsk Nickel. So palladium is one of the platinum group metals, also considered a precious metal. It's used in electronics, dentistry, hydrogen purification, but most of the use is in freeway catalytic converters in car exhaust systems. If we take a look at the palladium price movement in the last 10 years, it was very cheap in 2009, then it increased 2011, dropped in 2015 in the commodity slump, and now it's reaching again all-time highs. The higher palladium prices are due to demand deficits. So there is not enough palladium mined in the world in order to satisfy demand. And that's why the price goes up. In addition to the already present supply deficits, vehicle sales growth in 2016 and in the past 5 years have been increasing. On top of it, vehicle producers increase the palladium loading in their freeway catalytic converters. Just another bonus for palladium: hybrids that are very trendy use more palladium per vehicle than conventional gasoline engines. Very interesting. On the supply side, we see here that there is a structural decline in production, so there really haven't been any additional projects in the palladium world to satisfy global demand. The future is expected to get even better for the palladium price because demand is expected to grow and there isn't enough production. So the palladium net market balance is negative and that deficit is expected to grow. If we look at the cost curve, the average cost curve is around $750 per ounce. The current price is a bit above $800 per ounce, but with the increased deficits, we can certainly see higher palladium prices. And I wouldn't be surprised if palladium breaks 1,000, given that already some global producers have costs above $1,100 per ounce. So the outlook for palladium and therefore for Norilsk Nickel, which has nickel a positive outlook, copper a very positive outlook, and palladium a very positive outlook, is again positive. We have deficits, not so much projects coming online to satisfy global demand. Some say that there is the risk of electric vehicles taking over. Yes, I expect electric vehicles to be very, very significant in the future. However, I still expect gasoline vehicles to also grow, so the demand for palladium is not going to go away. If there isn't a disruptor coming that changes the world and we immediately switch to electric vehicles. Somehow I see that difficult. I expect much higher electric vehicles market share, but I also expect a much larger market for vehicles because the developed world and their increases in demand for vehicles. How to invest in palladium? Well, the biggest palladium miners are Norilsk Nickel, Sibanye Gold, an African miner that acquired a platinum palladium mine in the States, and a pure palladium play, not a diversified one, is North American Palladium. So for those interested, you might want to look at that. Of course, you can also buy coins and bars of palladium, which can be easily bought, but you have to see how easy it is to sell them when you actually need to sell them. So a little bit more difficult. What you can do for more liquidity is buy a palladium ETF, where you buy a part of the palladium stored in some vaults around the world. But you pay 0.5 to 0.6 fee on that. So I think it's better to own Norilsk than to own an ETF where you pay such a high fee for just keeping palladium. You can buy Norilsk, which has a lot of palladium in the ground. Same thing, no fee, plus a 10% dividend. Interesting. The risks, there is always risk. The risk for Palladium is a recession. Lower car production until the inventories are sold, much lower Palladium demand, and the stock price might go very, very low. So that's always the risk because, yes, Palladium is a precious metal, but it's also an industry metal. So I think it's not so precious as gold to increase when there is trouble, and it's not so precious not to decrease when there is a problem in the industry. So a little bit risky metal, but the outlook is very positive. So it's another plus for investments that are diversified and where one part of those is in Palladium. Thank you for watching. If you have any comments, any insights on Palladium, Palladium investments that I have missed that are very interesting, low cost, please share them below in the comments. I always look forward to your comments. If you like the content, click like, subscribe if you haven't subscribed yet, and I'll see you in the next video.